we've had a digital operating platform. So for us, the past 8 months has just been a progression of our journey. It's not been any kind of pivot or anything of that sort. In fact, the fact that we were digital and completely paperless has helped us actually grow very healthily in this space. For instance, in the last 8 odd months, we've been growing at a very robust pace in every single month. We are currently the fastest growing insurer. And what is even more heartening is that we are growing even health. Everyone expects that you would have grown, but we are growing even in motor, private car, which is our focus area, and that has also seen triple digit growth. And for us, health and motor, both of these have been constant focus areas. They've been the focus area for the past 2 years since we started our operations. Health is not a post-pandemic realization for us. We've always been bullish on health. And unlike a lot of newer companies that go motor first or TP first, we've always been focused on a mix of health and motor. And motor, we focused on private car, which is predominantly OD driven, own damage driven. We had to really push for people to adopt remote survey as a method of survey. But now our adoption rates have reached 50 to 60%. And you can imagine that our claims productivity has doubled in this period because of this adoption. Similarly, for us, our policy, the acquisition process has always been 100% paperless. So, in fact, some of the things that the regulator has brought out now, which is OTP-based, digital policy acquisition, is something that we had written to the regulator a while back while starting our operations, and we've been doing that OTP-based signature for a while now. We are continuing, and we are just continuing along our journey. What has actually helped us in some sort of a way, it's been a tailwind for us. Open API Gateway basically exposes our entire technology stack through a platform to any third-party developer who could belong to any startup, a tech startup, or any other partner or any service provider who wishes to integrate and provide services to us. And how it's different, usually, it's a server-to-server integration, or it's an API integration where the technology team of both the organizations get involved. But this is a platform where all our APIs are exposed. The sign-up is extremely simple. Once you sign up, you can easily, get the documentation for the API, and you can read through it. The signatures are pretty simple, and you can also test it out there. So the integration, which would have been a matter of months, has been cut down to a matter of weeks. We have APIs across the value chain. Two big milestones in the customer journey are the purchase journey and the claims journey. So we have APIs around that right now, but we are constantly enhancing the entire suite of or the list of APIs that we have available, and we are making it more and more granular. For instance, a claims journey, you could have one API or you could have five APIs. So now, and some partners want to have a more granular view of the journey. So we are creating more and more APIs and creating more and more granular journeys, and we'll be constantly enhancing this stack of APIs to actually be able to provide both our partners as well as end consumers a real-time view or a real-time engagement with our own customer journeys, which have been designed very thoughtfully. So today, for motor, for health, you can all the purchase and buy journey APIs and all the claim journey APIs are exposed. We are slowly enhancing the stack, including more and more granular APIs, as well as including other servicing aspects. And renewal is also part of it. We've also enhanced our entire data stack, and we've implemented a data lake, which is a bedrock and which is one of the first foundations for adopting new AI and ML techniques. So that's another big thing that we've done. It has helped that we are on cloud. So cloud native, which may be a transformation journey for others, was a setup journey for us, because we are, again, the only insurer, I think, to have all the applications, including the core application, which is SAP on cloud. So for us to expose our APIs is far easier. For us to adopt platforms like SageMaker that's there on AWS is far easier. A milestone kind of thing that we've done is we've launched a truly digital motor insurance product in the market, which doesn't exist. We launched a product called Switch. Basically, today you buy a motor insurance, it assumes it gives you cover for 365 days a year, right? Assuming you're driving 365 days a year. But when during the pandemic, a lot of the information that we were getting is people are saying, I'm not driving my car every day. We are in lockdown. Why are you making me pay insurance now? So we created a product which had a very simple premise that if you don't use, don't pay. So the days that you're not using the car, you can switch off your insurance and you won't be billed for that day. It's different at many, many levels. One is it is completely usage based. Second is the pricing apart from usage is also dependent on the driver and driver's experience. Third, it's a float policy. It is multi-vehicle. So you can cover under the same policy, you can cover three vehicles and one two-wheeler, two cars, or one car and two two-wheelers, any combination. The fourth is that the entire product is digital. It's an app. There is no physical copy, no PDF, nothing. The moment you buy the product, which will take you under a minute to buy, you have to activate, you have to download an app, and that's your policy. I'm one of the first customers, probably I'm the first customer of this product, and I have seen at least a 60% cost saving. AI is still a part of our journey right now, because you'd be aware that to start really using these machine learning techniques, you need a certain body of data, right? To train the algorithms and to train the program or the model. So over the last 2 years odd, we've actually developed that body of data. And now we're in the process of developing several algorithms which could primarily work to on the claim side right now to help us identify red flags in claims. It is also we are also developing algorithms which would help us identify good and bad cohorts from an underwriting perspective. As a early stage of developing real-time dynamic pricing models. Today, our pricing models are very rule and grid-based in the industry. So we are trying to move to a real-time dynamic pricing kind of model, build our data lake further, and we develop our algorithms further. We expect that next year we'll be in a position, starting next year, we'll be in the position of using some AI methodologies and some AI APIs to actually simplify our claims journeys primarily. From the fact that it took us almost 2 months to get the approvals to expose this API stack, I can tell you we have very strong InfoSec protocols. For all our applications, we have the vulnerability testing protocol, and it goes through a very stringent process of evaluation before we get the approval to expose any of our APIs to the public. In terms of structure also, our InfoSec sits under risk, so it's a independent control function, and they have independent of whether an application or an API can be exposed to the public or a portal can be exposed to the public, and they have veto powers, which is why I'm telling you it took us about 2 months to actually get to this point to remove all the observations that they had. So it's very important to maintain independence of the InfoSec function, which is what we've done structurally.